Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters. I really appreciate your presence here, coming here, sharing this beautiful evening with us. We know this is all about Linus, but I'm not going to talk so much about Linus today, because Linus is a symbol of environmental destruction. When environment destroyed, we people suffer. But how and why we allow Linus to happen? It's because we don't really care. It's not that we don't care about Linus, but we didn't care about what the government was doing. We allowed the government to do what they want without consulting us. We allowed the government to do what they like until they don't even care to consult us before they do anything. Linus is a symbol of environmental destruction, but it's going to happen in Kuantan. I'm going to talk about what's going to happen in Perak, in our place. The same thing is going to happen in Perak. You just look at Manjung now. Manjung and Pulau Pangko is the only place in Perak where we can go swimming, where we can go for a nice, beautiful beach and a clean water. But that's all in 2 or 3 years' time, we can never have it anymore. It's because one of the biggest oil or tin oil factory is going to be built. And it's going on now. If you go to Teluk Rubia, you can see the biggest tin oil or smelting factory is under construction. In 2 years' time, you will find the longest jetty in Teluk Rubia. And in 2 years' time, you can see 40 biggest ships in the world docking in Teluk Rubia. And what will happen after that? The fishermen will suffer. You can never go to Teluk Batik anymore. And how this happened is because we didn't care about what the government was doing, and the government never really cared to consult us before they do anything. And now Teluk Rubia is going to be destroyed forever. We can never have Teluk Batik anymore. But Teluk Batik, Manjung, Lumut will become Batut in 2 or 3 years' time. The next one. Just approved 2,000 or 500 acres of land is going to be developed in Tanjung Hantu for another iron ore and smelting company. Another one will be also in Teluk Senangin. 150 acres of forest reserve has been degazetted to be used as an LNG factory. Now, Tanjung Hantu is the forest reserve, first-class forest reserve, where you cannot have any development there. It is only reserved for education and research, but now it's going to be totally destroyed. For what? For LNG and for iron ore company. And another one for all of you who are from Ipoh. For the last 2 years, since 2011 and 2012, more than 5,000 acres of forest reserve in Gunung Kobu has been degazetted. You know where is Gunung Kobu? That is where all your source of water for Ipoh people. 5,000 people of forest reserve have been degazetted, and logging has started recently. And we can imagine, in 2 years' time, Ipoh will face water shortage. Now, this is what we are going to suffer if we allow Linus to continue. If we allow Linus to continue, the government will carry on with all sorts of projects. And what is all these small projects? So, ladies and gentlemen, thanks a lot for coming and sharing this evening with us. Thank you very much.
Okay, terima kasih banyak. Okay, next. We
我们邀请来自霹雳绿色先锋的主席黄云龙先生来致辞。多谢大家，好欢迎所有的叶部居民出席今日下午这个盛会。2012年，地球已经是病了。 咁樣好多先進嘅國家都已經係想盡辦法去點樣去綠化佢哋環境。 佢點樣去保護佢嘅環境，同埋為佢哋嘅啊國家嘅公民嘅健康同埋啊佢嘅生態環境著想。馬來西亞係我哋嘅國家，每一分嘅每一寸嘅土地都係啊係屬於馬來西亞人民嘅，都係屬於在座各位嘅。各位認唔認同？啊，我哋愛我哋嘅國家，但係我哋嘅政府唔知愛唔愛我哋。今日所有嘅出席者嚟到呢一度，都係希望同我哋嘅政府講。我哋要 stop Linus， 我哋唔要 Linus 喺馬來西亞、喺關丹、喺度啊，去投入佢嘅生產。因為到目前為止 ，Linus 廠家都未同我哋講佢點樣去處理佢生產出嚟嘅稀土廢料，同埋生產稀土、提煉稀土過程中生產出嚟嘅廢氣同埋嗰啲廢水。到目前為止，他沒有給我們一個很詳細的報告，我們所以人民的力量是有限的，我們愛全部馬來西亞人民愛上下一心，團結就是力量。下一屆大選啊，如果我們的政府一意孤行這樣去出發出這個臨時執政準照給這個 Linus 公司去投入生產的話，下一個大選就呼籲所有人民去用你手中的一票去揀出一個為人民的健康著想和為人民政府的一個好的政府，去投出你神聖的一票。 OK， 多謝
多謝黃雲龍先生。 And now 我要給其他民政部Jasmine, ada bloggers di Peti Pera. Dia akan mengucap dalam bahasa Malaysia.
Salam sejahtera. Tajia Xiao Wu Hao. Salam sejahtera kepada semua warga Perak yang telah meluangkan masa untuk menghadiri perhimpunan membantah pembinaan kilang Linus di Gebeng, Kuantan. Okay. Tahu tak kenapa kita berada di sini hari ini? Untuk apa?
Stop Linus!
Yes, stop Linus. Ya, terima kasih. Ya. Now, kerajaan menyatakan bahawa ia adalah selamat dan tidak ada bahaya dan kesan buruk terhadap alam sekitar dan ke atas rakyat Malaysia. Betul ke ini?
Betul
ke? Kalau you tengok logo tu, bahaya tu. Tapi kerajaan Malaysia cakap tak bahaya.
Bahaya.
Ah, bahaya, betul?
Betul.
Okey. Now, kerajaan Australia tidak mahu membina kilang Linus di negara mereka. Tetapi negara kita, kerajaan kita sungguh baik hati membenarkan Linus, okey, kilang Linus di bina di Gebeng, Kuantan. Di Malaysia, semua boleh. Ya? Yeah?
Semua boleh.
Semua boleh, yes. Negara Australia menghargai nyawa setiap rakyat mereka. Tetapi kerajaan Malaysia tidak menghargai nyawa rakyat Malaysia. Nyawa kita pun sama. Okay? Kerajaan Malaysia harus okey, mengambil berat tentang setiap nyawa rakyat Malaysia di sini. Di manakah slogan kerajaan yang menyatakan kerajaan rakyat didahulukan di dalam isu Linus? Kita berada hari ini di sini, okey, untuk menyuarakan dalam satu suara untuk memberitahu kerajaan Malaysia bahawa kita membantah rakyat Perak membantah ya pembinaan kilang Linus di Gebeng, Kuantan. That's all. Thank you. Terima kasih ya.
Oh, 大家期待嘅时刻投票，等多阵先啦。等我哋邀请最后一个代表嚟发表意见，佢哋系来自忠贞规宣嘅代表。 如果有上網朋友、上 Facebook 朋友，一定知道中真快線係啲咩嘢。佢係一個啊，我係等佢哋自己介紹佢哋自己嘅 page 啊。
各位好。其实今天我看到每一次从我们从第一次帮 Andy Linus SFSL 举办这些一周一周去的这种座谈会的时候呢，刚开始反应其实是不是很好，因为他我们的这位兄弟其实也是我们的一员，而且刚开始的时候我们有体会过，就是赴场的人不到30多个，到今天这样的人数已经是那个表示说那个 awareness 已经是越散越远了。而且到这时间呢，我要强调的就是我要告诉你一个消息，就是 Negeri Sembilan 的714他们那边集中了100多人，但他们举办不到5分钟就完全被警察驱赶了。至少我们这边我们的警察还是蛮合作的。现在呢，我要跟你讲的就是我们马来西亚我们面对最大的问题就是我们的媒体完全不自由。我们的 Himpunan Hijau 我们的 SMSL 他们在很多地方都有举办这一种将消息传达出去的 awareness 的座谈会诊，问题就是很多都被媒体遮盖，他们从来没有机会拿到一个全国版的新闻，即使他们那一个项目是做到多么的成功。因此我们才会说在网上帮忙推动这一种一周一周每一个周都发起的活动，而今天坦白讲就是靠那个网络的力量，我们才能得到很多很多很多政府不要让我们知道的消息。就比如这个 Linus， 就比如Pengarang Johor Pengarang 的，还有这位啊，刚听到这位先生讲的，其实这边你们的那一个 port， 还有很多我们不知道的。Sabah Sarawak 那边更严重，因为他们那边的新闻呢是比我们这边封锁的更多。所以呢，现在我们是代表 Facebook， 我们是代表一个网络力量。如果你们有上面子书的话，希望你们能也进来我们的 page， 我们的 page 叫做中正快讯，从那边呢尽量把里面的消息 share 出去，尽量让所有的人都知道我们的政府是怎样的，不要让那些我们应该知道的东西给我们知道，因为这些是我们的基本Human right 来的，这个是我们生活在这个这边以我们的公民我们应该知道的东西来的。所以今天我也不多说，毕竟投票已经要开始了。不过今天出席的人我要跟你们讲一句，你们都很棒，请你们为自己鼓掌，谢谢。